Good afternoon, everybody. I'm glad having been invited to the Magnolia conference because I believe that Magnolia is a great content management system that serves shaping the digital business of Migros.ch. I'm in charge of the website Migros.ch. We don't sell any products. I will start with three takeaways I want you to understand. First, we believe that it's essential to build a content strategy because it's the fuel for business, for doing business. And the second takeaway is that we drive effectiveness through content relevance and seamless customer journeys throughout Migros.ch. And third takeaway is that we want to shift efficiency through scaling solutions and automation with a little help from Magnolia. For the people coming from abroad, I will make a short, I tell you the story how Migros was founded in 1925 by Gottlieb Duttweiler. He started with 100,000 francs capital and bought 6 Migros sales trucks. And he sold 6 products, coffee, sugar. And this company grew and grew until in 1994. This is the picture of the last Migros sales truck somewhere near St. Gallen. And now, these are the numbers from last year. We've got over 2 million members of the cooperative. We've got over 90,000 employees working for Migros. And we've got over 1,300,000 square meter floor space. And the group sales are over 26 billion. The group has grown. We sell chocolate, we sell non-food, we sell consumer electronics. It's really huge, and every company has got its own digital touch points. And many of them are working with the Magnolia CMS, or the most important brands driving sales and traffic are working with Magnolia Content Management System. So now I come to the presentation. I'm talking about content marketing because I believe it's very important to connect the company DNA, which we have at Migros, with unique brands and scape a unique story around the products. We've got loads of content on Migros.ch. We've got over 8,000 HTML sites, and our customers, Google said that we've got 20 million visits per year. I know we've got more, but in the end, without selling anything, Migros.ch is very successful. But the problem is, in the end, that we don't know what's the value of our content. So we can't measure the research online purchase offline effect. And now the key question for me is, or I answered it already, is that content marketing is crucial for the success of Migros.ch or for the digital business of Migros.ch. So we try to amplify the impact of our owned media, like Migros.ch, like Migros.ch/Cumulus, like Famigro, to have an impact on bricks and mortar. Because we believe, or we know, that many people inform themselves about products. Hundreds of thousands of people are informing themselves every week about products we sell, and we believe that they go shopping afterwards. So I think it's essential that we present our product in a unique, optimized way, and that we measure how effective content drives sale or traffic to the point of sale. So as I said, content marketing is the fuel for both the digital and the offline business. Why? Because it's very difficult if you think about the cucumber. We sell in Switzerland over 100,000 cucumbers a day. It's very difficult to say, or I am asked, how many cucumbers do you sell with Migros.ch?
Brief overview.
And I have to admit, I don't even sell a slice of a cucumber. That's actually my problem. So I have to answer in my content strategy what makes the cucumber special. And I don't believe it's the price. I believe it's the context, the quality, the experience people have with Migros, and the convenience, the anywhere commerce, e-commerce, that you can buy a cucumber whenever you want, in whichever package, maybe as a recipe. And why I believe it's very important to shout out with Migros.ch that we've got the best cucumbers, the best Swiss cucumbers, is because we know that our customer, if we look at the user journey of 1 year, he's got at least 128 touch points with the point of sale, with digital campaigns, with Migros.ch, second screen on the iPad, and we want to deliver the content in the right form at the right moment to amplify sales in the end. But that's not an easy process. So we don't just go out and say we've got the best cucumber in the world, just buy it, that won't work. We have to have a content strategy which is long-term view. Here I've got some two statistics from the first one from the UK that says, that's what I said, that the sales, Verkäufe unten, is not as important as the awareness or the engagement or the loyalty we can achieve with content. The second statistic says that the homepage, Migros.ch, followed by the newsletter, followed by social media, is very important to shout out your message throughout the touch points. So now I will show you first how we achieved our goals with three campaigns we integrated fully into Migros.ch. What's special about these cases, or what's new about these cases, that I hosted the content completely on Migros.ch on a campaign server. So it's not in the past, the content was hosted somewhere out in the world at an agency. And that gives me complete control over the content, making it possible to share content over different touch points. First, I will talk about 100 Things. It's our summer campaign. It shall inspire customers to taste products Migros is selling. Then I will show you how we engage customers with A versus B, a campaign running now. And last but not least, how we build trust with customers. And this is a campaign or a project lasting for 4 years, Phone uns Phone here, which shall amplify our uniqueness. Because Migros is producing most of the products we sell in our own Migros industry, and that's a competitor advantage, I believe. Okay, case one, how do we inspire people? In the summer campaign, we wanted to show that even if it's raining, people can have a party with friends. And the case is 100dinge.migros.ch. And we, as usual, we used TV, print, a book, and a poster campaign to promote this this whole story. And it's actually the idea behind this that we produced a little book giving 100 ideas to people what they can do in summer with their children or by their own. This is the book. We sold it for 7.70 francs, and it has been sold over 100,000 times up to now. And here is the website we produced, and it's making use of a little bit small data. So if it's the weather is okay, we will show another idea than if it's raining. And we have produced exclusively 30 videos, how-to videos and slideshows for this campaign. It's fully responsive, so working on smartphones and iPad, performing well. So that was the rich content I was talking about. We even have user-generated content, a very difficult story, but it seems to work. And in the end, we make suggestions of what you could buy after this inspiration. I will show you the short clip.
Schweinsfackelspieß Grillmi. Rote Kopfsalat an Asbest. Pulleflügel Optigal. Hamburger, ein Klassik. Eine Regenparty feiern. Eins von 100 Dingen, die man diesen Sommer gemacht haben sollte.
And now I come to the results. I won't tell you explicit numbers, but what's amazing or interesting is that in the past we always had in a campaign, in every campaign, we just have a peak. So you put a campaign into the TV air, put it into print, and you have a peak. But now by integrating the content on Magnolia, I could use all the touch points to interconnect together and to really drive the power Migros.ca has got. So I focused on the summer campaign, and it was possible. If you compare up there, the first peak, where we used all the media you can buy in Switzerland, Sunday papers, NZZ 20 Minuten, TV spots, even the newsletter we send out. After this peak, the second peak is mainly online. So I managed to achieve a success in traffic, reaching almost 3/4 of the effect I had with the first campaign. So I think that's the right way to go. It's just the first proof of concept, and we will follow this way. So from now on, every campaign on Migros.ch will be hosted on a central campaign server, having the advantage that I can change text, or my web producers can change text 5 to 12 on Saturday night, what happened with this campaign. One day before the launch, we had to change the landing page. So that wouldn't have been possible if we wouldn't have done it with Magnolia in our special setup. And here at the end is how I think personally. This is not from Forrester or somebody else. What I think, how the content value process at the Migros is taking place. In the first place, we have to have an editorial calendar of what topics we want to play. Second, the content creation, it has to be decided, do we outsource the content creation? Is it something communications has to do, or is it a marketing job? In Migros, the reality is that this will be decentral. We can't centralize this. But the content operations, I believe in this, that we centralize them. So we just use one content management system and not many. And I will steer this. And next comes the content marketing. And I think there the essential point is that you've got an idea how to communicate your message through many multiple touch points. And that you develop a story system, how you want to make campaigns more intelligent. And in the end, how do you measure traffic? That's also something quite difficult to answer. It's easier to measure how many cucumbers you sell in Migros than to measure how many people looked at a text or what was the impulse. I come to the second case called A versus B, how we want to customers to experience our brand or our product. We want them to love our product. So we decided to cast two bands who compete against each other. It's a battle of bands, and they're related with a product. And the users can vote which product is more of their taste, and the winner will be at the point of sale in the end. So I will show you a short video. I won't show you the full clip.
Live from the Micro Secret Lab, Pinkberry and Upro O2 Raspberry Lime versus Brooks Prize 3000 and Upro O2 Pineapple Lime. The battle of tastes. Only one will survive.
So that's a short look into that. Korea Pop, it's called, the first band, I didn't know this. And this is the website. It's integrated in Migros, so you can come back to the Migros main corporate website. It's connected with Phone and Phone here on the right. It's also the third project I'm going to show you. And it's also fully responsive, and we achieved over 300,000 views with a clip of 17 seconds teasing A versus B. So that's quite interesting. We own our own YouTube channel, a branded channel, and we've got up to now over 2 million views. Google told us last week. So I come to the third case. It's Phone on Phone here, and it will show how Migros is unique, so that we produce our iced tea on our own. And we show how little kids experience Migros nowadays.
Pizza Tonno, Anna's Best. Iced Tea Zitrone. Pasta Candida. Rahmglasse Vanille. Das sind nur einige von rund 10.000 Produkten, die wir übrigens selber in der Schweiz herstellen. Migros. Von uns, von hier.
And I think that demonstrates how Migros has changed, because back when I was 5 years old, in the 70s, I waited on Wednesday afternoon for the Migros sales truck to come in our street, somewhere in Bottmingen in Basel, and I was jumping for the ice cream, the vanilla ice cream, and that was my experience with Migros.ch. That's why I'm a Migros kind, how we called it, but nowadays you don't have many Migros kinds left, and many people, expats, they simply don't know that the handy, das Waschmittel, that it's a Migros product, that the iced tea is a Migros product. And that's why we started this project lasting for 3 or 4 years at least. And it was very important to build it with Magnolia fully integrated into Migros.ch to be able to update it frequently. So that's the website. It's got a parallax effect on the top. You can move phone and phone here. We created all the Migros products in 3D to be able to build these fonts in the end. And online, we produced a lot of content, recipes, to give added value to the customers. We integrated a live stream showing how the Migros industry is working. It's a little bit monophonic, but it's just a factory, but it's interesting to see how things work. And we updated the page. The project was launched in March, and we updated it already two times. So we're quite busy working on this one. And it's always in three languages and hosted on this campaign server. And here you have a glance at the recipes we've got. From Saison Küche, it's also Migros, they got their own magazine with recipes. But these recipes aren't in Magnolia, so we had to import them by hand. Not really cool. And we focused on three products: the Handy, Waschmittel, or the Abspülmittel, and the Bifidus, yogurt, and iced tea. And what's interesting is the connection between off and online here, that in the end there will be in 128 point of sales, there will be products and people showing the products to customers. So you will be able at certain points, there's an event calendar, to go to a Migros on a Saturday and bake bread with your children. So that's quite an experience, I think, and builds trust. And then after this, the Migros industry wanted us to build a website for iced tea. And we also built this, the content is on Magnolia also. We built this, and also fully responsive to interconnect all the landing pages together. And that's quite a success, I think. So, how we use Magnolia, I won't go into detail, but in the end, Migros.ch is a huge universe of content, and we've got loads of landing pages, microsites. I steer a team, only web production, of about 40 plus people to maintain the site, and nearly every day I get some calls, could we make a new HR landing page for young talents, as an example. So there's quite a bit something going on. So I convinced a lot of people in the Migros that we upgrade to Magnolia 5.2. We upgraded to Magnolia 4.5 last year, which was a huge effort in many ways, but it worked out. And I think the argument for having all these microsites on the same platform is the control of the content and the responsivity. Many people in MGB, they've got the idea, they think, why isn't Magnolia like WordPress? You just press a button and it's mobile. What's the problem? Why does it cost over 100K every single move you make? But I think if you look at the complexity of this universe, it's not as simple as doing a blog on WordPress. So with a little help from Magnolia, I'm convinced that we build tools once and use them many times. In past, for every campaign, we built the form, we built the game, we built a picture gallery. Every year, we never used tools, and what we do now, we build a tool set that we can reuse for every campaign. And the same also with content. In past, we created loads of content. We got recipes all over the world on some servers, and nobody knows who's in charge. And I centralized this with the idea that we can serve the touch points. And what's my personal conclusion? That for me, IT is very important, but it's a hygiene factor. So if everything works, everybody's happy, but if Migros.ch is down, everybody will hang me up. So I think what I want to do is I have a solid basis, but go down with the cost for IT and invest the cost in content, because that's the flesh, that's the fuel, not only for owned media, also for earned media in the end. That's what I want to do. Thank you very much, and now I'm open for questions.